what is the growth that you expect in the industry in, say, the 5 to 10 years?
I don't know the numbers, but it is going to get bigger and bigger, because as we all see, it is now becoming, traditionally it was only computer science, but now it has sort of spread out in other disciplines, not just engineering, which we all know in mechanical, electrical, there is all computers, but now it has also gone and reached out to chemistry, biology, medical science. So as a whole, I think it's going to catch up with many other fields, and programming will become sort of a basic course that everyone will have to take in their school curriculum. And then building on top of that programming skills, people have to know how to apply programming skills for multiple disciplines. So there is a very big scope now.
What are the kind of opportunities that students have after completing their degree, both corporate and academic?
Okay, so first corporate. So once you get with your bachelor's or master's degree, then there are many programming opportunities where you will apply the skills of programming languages that you know to develop products for that company. There are service-oriented jobs where the company is acting as a consultant for other disciplines, where the knowledge of, again, programming comes in, and then you can apply that there. In India now, we are also seeing growth of just product-based companies, not just services but and consultancy, but there are companies, for example, Zoho, which is an Indian company building products for the global market from scratch. So that's where even a person gets to design a new product, see where the technology can be applied, and work on that. If you have research experience as part of your bachelor's or master's program, say, for example, you have done a research thesis in any of these two degrees, then you also get an opportunity to work on a research problem, which is different from the product-oriented companies. In research, you start with a question that everybody, or at least the company, is looking forward to, maybe not down in a short-term basis, but for a long-term. They want to think about what sort of technology will get applied there. The product as it is does not exist in the market. So here it's more open-ended, and you could then apply skills from different verticals within computer science to address this problem and come up with a solution. Now, the second part was about the academia. Once you graduate with bachelor's and master's, those who don't have master's can go and study, get their master's, and those who already have either of these two and want to pursue it at the level of research, they can opt for PhDs. Talking about the research opportunities, once you get into research, you will probably take more courses in whichever school or university you join. And then again, pick up one of the verticals and dig deeper to define your own problem, come up with solution, present it to the community. So that's the research way of developing a career. And there also, there are many opportunities available in almost all top universities.
How are the facilities at Pitts Goa compared to other Indian colleges or also other universities abroad for, say, as far as research or like practicals are concerned?
Yes. So for the bachelor's program, it is arguably one of the best private colleges in India. So that's an advantage. And with that, you get almost all the basic foundational courses in computer science that you would get in any other place in the world. So once you do those basic programming courses and foundation courses in computer science, then there are many electives which are available. And those also we offer for example, if we take AI, artificial intelligence or machine learning, we have faculty here who is at par in their research career with anybody outside in the world. And you could then take specific courses in these disciplines. And similarly, in other areas also, we have labs and equipments and resources. For example, in IoT, in mobile computing, in computer networks, we have labs on campus where you a student can learn the programming, but not just that programming, he can apply, he or she can apply that and develop prototypes and then test it out in the real world, collect data, then go through the cycle of upgrading the design and trying it out. So all the experience that you would have received in any other top colleges in India, you would receive at BITS Pilani in the Goa campus.
So what kind of courses would CS students be taking, and like what are the things that they will learn throughout the course, the undergraduate degree?
So for any computer science, the foundational courses are data structures, algorithm, complexity theory of algorithm, theory of computation. So those are primarily theory courses. Then comes databases, computer networks, operating system, computer architecture. So programming languages. So all those create a foundation of computer science, and you can build on top of that and take any cutting edge course or elective that's available in the computer science. So first 2 years, or 2.5 years can go into taking these foundational courses, but then the rest of the time, or rest of the semester, you can take the high-end courses or the elective courses, where you will work more closely with the faculty. In the foundational courses, the classes are a little big in strength. There are many students, but once you pass and are done with the foundational courses, you work almost on one-on-one basis with the faculty for these elective courses, where you pick up the concepts in that elective, but also maybe also try out your hands in research. There, one of the elements of those courses is you get to read research papers. Then you get to present your own ideas in front of the faculty and the students. And you also can then, if you have your own ideas in mind through projects or programming assignments in the course, you could even get your hand dirty with research and try it out.
Okay, sir, is there anything you would like to address to, say, the first year students who will be like beginning with their courses, or say the next batch of incoming students, any piece of advice that you would
like? Yes. So from my knowledge, when the students enter any engineering college, I'm not just talking about BITS, but any good engineering college, what they come with a very strong foundation of physics, chemistry, and maths. Where most of the concepts are there in a lot of textbooks. There are many or plenty of textbooks available. There are good numbers of faculty, tutors available so that you can get those concepts. But let's say if I'm just talking about computer science as one of the engineering disciplines, once you enter into that, it gets far wider, right? It's far more wide as compared to a narrow topic of physics or chemistry or maths. Then the textbooks are also there, and which are far more in number. And every textbook comes with a different approach towards the subject. For example, if I take computer networks, what we say, there is a top-down approach and there is a right bottom-up approach. So in one approach, let's say you bottom-up, you first learn about the physical network, and then you slowly learn about TCP/IP and HTTP and internet. While in the other approach, which we say top-down, you first learn what is the internet, and then you see what is the TCP/IP, and then you come down to the final physical layer of, let's say, wireless communication. So there is no standard one path for any of these subjects. So be open to look at the same subject from different perspective. Be open to read multiple of the textbook and pick whatever suits you or whatever is the best that you think you can apply. The questions are not also well defined, unlike in the, let's say, multiple choice questions, right, that you get through with many entrance exams. Right, the question is there and there are four choices and you select one, and you tend to get into a habit of, right, eliminating the wrong answers and come down to the right answer. Or you try to match it with a pattern. Right, you see the words and you understand the pattern, and you try to immediately, right, tend to match it, and solve that question. While in the engineering, most of the questions you would see, they will not fit a pattern, or you cannot eliminate the wrong answer and come to the right answer. You might have to dig deeper and deeper to understand that question, and you open up multiple different topics, and you have to go through all those topics to finally come back to the question you are looking at. For example, let me give you an example. If you want to build a robot which understands the surroundings, the environment, and can maneuver itself within that environment, there are many things that go into such a piece. There is neural network, there are sensors, there is communication, and each of this is a different area in itself. So what you need to learn in each of this so that you can understand those concepts and finally apply it to whatever is the problem at your hand, that skill is different from your PCM skill of passing the exams or entrance exams. So my recommendation is change the gears, change the mindset once you enter engineering school or engineering college, and then be ready to apply yourself for the engineering questions and try to become an engineer.